you're obviously very familiar with, O Come, O Come, Emmanuel, sung from the original Latin. The text is a versification of the great O Antiphons of Advent, which are the antiphons to be sung right before the Magnificat and Vespers each of the 7 days before Christmas Eve. The first one is O Sapientia, which is O Wisdom from on high. You'll recognize that these are different verses from O Come, O Come, Emmanuel. O Adonai, O Lord of Might, O Rex Gentium, King of the Gentiles, which in the translation that we all know is Desire of Nations. Clavis Davi, which is Key of David. Oriens, which is Dayspring, otherwise known as the Morning Star. Radis Jesse, which is the root of the rod of Jesse. And then finally, Emmanuel, which is God with us. When they versified it into Latin, they reversed the order. And in that reverse order, the acrostic spells out arrow cross, starting with Emmanuel and then beginning with Sapientia, which means I come tomorrow, or really I will be tomorrow, which is a very rich tradition. The next thing that we're going to sing is a hymn by St. Ambrose, the Veni Redemptor Vinci, which was one of the earliest Advent hymns. And it became, and then Luther adapted and translated it into German, and it became known as Nunquam Jacobi Pilot. And now, if you know the hymn today in English, you'll probably know it as Savior of the Nations Come. And it's a very Lutheran sounding hymn. And one of the ways that it's really neat is that so many composers have treated it in so many different ways over all of the different ages. And so the one that we get here tonight is by Samuel Scheib, who was a composer about 100 years before J.S. Bach. And you'll get to hear the imitative point, the chorale tune, sung by various different voices. And as it was written by Luther, it became a central point of piety in Advent, being sung by almost every Lutheran church as the first hymn on the first Sunday in Advent. So, Nunquam Jacobi Pilot and Veni Redemptor Vinci.
Oh, my God.
then you have another chance on Sunday at 7 o'clock at Chapel of the Cross, where I'm the choir master. We have our